This section will familiarize you with preventing pollution of the marine environment. This is an example of the damage an oil spill can cause. This table shows the quantity of crude oil in millions of tons that are transported at sea. This quantity increases each year. This table shows the quantity of oil spilled. As you can see, the amount of oil spilled has decreased rapidly the last years. The two previous pages show that even though the quantity of oil transported at sea is increasing, the amount of oil spilled is decreasing. The main reasons for this are implementation of MARPOL, the International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships, companies' awareness and understanding of the importance of pollution prevention, better follow-up from flag state and other authorities. In the USA, the accidents involving the Exxon Valdez and Megaborg were in focus and were well covered by the media and press. This influenced public opinion. The result was the establishing of the Oil Pollution Act of 1990, OPA 90. The media showed pictures of the rich animal life and the magnificent coastline in Alaska covered with oil and the suffering of dying seals and seabirds. This presentation made a strong impression, which forced the US Congress to realize that the existing international conventions had to be reviewed and improved in order to protect and take care of American interests. American lawyers developed the Oil Pollution Act, and the Congress supported the proposed act. The main stipulations in OPA 90 are the threat of unlimited responsibility, demands for double hulls, direct access to the means in P&I companies in case of indemnity due to accidents, higher-graded demands meant for the crew regarding narcotics and alcohol testing, use of pilots in sensitive waters. Upon entering American waters, OPA requires drill training according to OPA 90 regulations. The drill training should be logged and reported according to the ship owner or operator's policy. OPA 90 regulations are in force for all types of ships. The International Convention for the Prevention of Pollution from Ships, 1973, modified in 1978, is better known as MARPOL 7378. This convention is one of the most important international agreements on the subject of marine pollution. These regulations are made for the preservation of human environments in general and the marine environment in particular. The goal is to achieve the complete elimination of international pollution of the marine environment by oil and other harmful substances, and the minimization of accidental discharge of such substances. Detailed regulations covering the various sources of ship-generated pollution are contained in six annexes. Annex 1, Regulation for the Prevention of Pollution by Oil. Annex 2, Regulation for the Control of Pollution by Noxious Liquid Substances in Bulk. Annex 3, Regulation for the Prevention of Pollution by Harmful Substances in Packaged Form. Annex 4, Regulation for the Prevention of Pollution by Sewage from Ships. Annex 5, Regulation for the Prevention of Pollution by Garbage from Ships. Annex 6, Regulation for the Prevention of Air Pollution from Ships. Annex 1 of MARPOL 7378, Regulation for the Prevention of Pollution by Oil. Chapter 1. Generally, it covers subjects such as surveys and inspection, the form and duration of certificate. Chapter 2. Requirements for control of operational pollution cover subjects such as segregated ballast tanks, crude oil washing, the oil discharge monitor, the oil record book, retention of oil on board. Chapter 3. Requirements for minimizing oil pollution from oil tankers due to side and bottom damage cover subjects such as damage assumptions, subdivision and stability. Chapter 4. Prevention of pollution arising from an oil pollution incident covers subjects such as The Shipboard Oil Pollution Emergency Plan. Annex 2 of MARPOL 7378. Regulation for the control of pollution by noxious liquid substances in bulk. Annex 2 covers subjects such as the categorization and listing of noxious liquid substances, discharge of noxious liquid substances, pumping, piping and unloading arrangements, the cargo record book, survey and certification of chemical tankers, requirements for minimizing accidental pollution. Annex 3. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by harmful substances in packaged form. Annex 3 covers subjects such as packing, labeling, documentation, stowage, quantity limitations. Annex 4. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by sewage from ships. Annex 4 includes such items as surveys, the form and duration of certificate, discharge of sewage, standard discharge connection. Annex 5. Regulation for the prevention of pollution by garbage from ships. Annex 5 includes such items as the disposal of garbage outside special areas, special requirements for the disposal of garbage, the disposal of garbage within special areas, port state control on operational requirements. Annex 6. Regulation for the prevention of air pollution from ships. Included are guidelines for the emission of different substances, as well as specific requirements for testing, surveying, and certification and fuel quality.